So what could happen if this was a tree or a large beehive, like with a couple stacked up? Maybe the elderly queen is up here. Maybe she's 4 years old, which is old to a bee. Regular bees live 3 months to 5 months. 3 in the summer, 5 in the winter. They live longer in the winter, probably because of the law of averages, like birds pick them off in the summer and stuff like that. So their lifespan is generally 3 months. Plus, I think the wear and tear of the hard labor that they do. So a winter bee, female, 5 months. Summer, 3. So 3 to 5. If they can consume royal jelly all their life and transform into a queen bee, up to 3 to 5 years, 10 times the lifespan. And what happens is the elderly queen bee, probably the hive is so packed. Maybe there's a lot of burr comb. Maybe there's so many bees in there that she just physically couldn't get down, remember I said the bottom, to inspect where all those other bees were down there. And in their consciousness, they were thinking, I don't smell the queen. How many days ago did you smell the queen? I haven't been up to the top. Is she up there? I don't smell her. Because like ants, they're pheromone, they're scent oriented. So what they do is they start making queen cells because they're worried that maybe something happened to their queen. Or that this hive is too crowded, we gotta expand. They allow these queens to hatch, and then swarming occurs. Often the elderly queen is the one to swarm, but not always. She'll take off and a third of the colony will leave that entire radius of this hive and find a new place to replicate. Often it's the old queen. Sometimes it's the young virgin, but it's usually the old one that's like, oh, I'm out of here. Like, I don't want to mess with her. You know, like I've for the last 3 years, I've been quelling these damn virgin queens. I've had enough of them. I'm out of here. And she just takes off and hopefully finds another cave, hollow branch or hole in the ground, or a beekeeper like myself.